In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and voice, and darkness was on the face of the deep.
Target for the Apollo 11 astronauts, the moon at liftoff will be at a distance of 218,096 miles away. T-minus 60 seconds and counting. We passed.
It is July 16th, 1969, pad 39A at Cape Kennedy, Florida.
Neil Armstrong just reported back. It's been a real smooth countdown. We passed the 50-second mark. Power transfer is complete.
Three U.S. astronauts sit atop a huge 36-story high Saturn V rocket, gleaming in the morning sunlight. America is preparing to go for the moon.
Second stage tanks now pressurized. 35 seconds and counting. We are.
It has been 8 years since President John Kennedy committed the nation to land men on the moon and return them safely to Earth within this decade. Half a million people have worked on this project. $30 billion has been spent. Hundreds of millions of people around the world are watching and listening as the Saturn rocket prepares to roar into life. NASA's Jack King with the final seconds of the countdown.
10, 9, ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff.
A huge cloud of white smoke and orange flame leaps from the base of the Saturn rocket. 6 million pounds of rocket and spacecraft kicks and slowly begins to lift off the pad.
We got a roll program.
Neil Armstrong reporting the roll and pitch program, which puts Apollo 11 on proper heading.
Apollo 11 is go for the moon. The roar of the Saturn's engines rolls across 3.5 miles here at the Cape, shaking the grounds and the buildings. Apollo 11 is up and away.
One Bravo is a abort control mode. Altitude's 2 miles.
Houston, you're good at 1 minute.
The first step in the Apollo 11 mission gets off the ground right on time. Everything is go.
Yeah, everything looks good here.
Station. And ignition.
S4B is go.
11 Houston, thrust is go. All engines, you're looking good. Houston, you are go at 5 minutes.
Roger, you're Apollo 11, go.
Everyone's reporting go here in the control center.
So at 6 minutes, starting to get
worse. Roger, 11, you're go from the ground at 6 minutes. 11, this is Houston, you are go for staging.
Ground, we're 10 seconds away from this.
Standby for mode 4 capability.
Mode 4.
Mark, mode 4 capability.
Downrange 1,000 miles, altitude 101 miles.
Work out.
Apollo 11 still go on all sources.
Shut down.
Shut down right on time.
101.4 by 103.6.
Roger, shut down, and we copy 101.4 by 103.6. Apollo 11, this is Houston. You are confirmed to go for orbit.
Almost 3 hours later, it is go again. Apollo 11 fires up its main engine high over the Pacific Ocean to begin the three-day journey out to the moon, almost a quarter of a million miles away. On July 19th, Apollo 11 reaches the moon and goes into lunar orbit. One day later, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin leave astronaut Mike Collins alone in the command craft and descend toward the lunar surface.
We're go. Same time. We're go.
Armstrong is flying the Eagle lunar craft down to the surface himself as Buzz Aldrin relays their progress back to astronaut Charlie Duke on Earth.
Forward. Forward. 40 feet, down 2.5. Picking up some dust. Contact light. Okay, engine stop. ACA at a descent.
Out of
D. Host control, both all descent. Engine command override off. Engine arm off. 413 is in.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Listen, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
It is 4:17 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Neil Armstrong reports that man has made his first landing on another planet.
The auto targeting was taking us right into a football field sized crater with a large number of big boulders and rocks for about a 1 or 2 crater diameters around it. And it required us going in 66 and flying manually over the rock field to find a reasonably good area.
Roger, we copy. It was beautiful from here. Tranquility, over.
Buzz Aldrin looks out and reports his first view of the lunar surface.
What's around here, but it looks like a collection of just about every variety of shape, angularity, granularity, but every variety of rock you could find.
Right, Tranquility. Be advised, there are lots of smiling faces in this room and all over the world, over.
There are two of them up here.
Roger, it was a beautiful job, you guys.
And don't forget one in the command module.
Roger.
The Apollo 11 crew will go down in history, not for its colorful language. Neil Armstrong's words, as you heard them as he landed, were a laconic, Houston, Tranquility Base here. Eagle has landed. With those words, man landed on the moon, July 20th, 1969.
All right, Houston, Tranquility, over.
Tranquility, Houston, go ahead.
Roger, this is the LEM pilot. I'd like to take this opportunity to ask every person listening in, whoever, wherever they may be, to pause for a moment and contemplate the events of the past few hours and to give thanks in his or her own way. coming open at 109 hours, 8 minutes, 5 seconds.
It is now Sunday night, June 20th, and Neil Armstrong is about to become the first man to walk on the moon's surface.
I'm at the foot of the ladder. The lamb footbeds are only depressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches, although the surface appears to be very, very fine-grained as you get close to it. It's almost like a powder. Ground mass is very fine. I'm going to step off the lamb now. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. As the surface fine and powdery, I can kick it up loosely with my toe. It does adhere in fine layers, like powdered charcoal, to the sole and insides of my boot. I only go in a small fraction of an inch, maybe an eighth of an inch, but I can see the footprints of my boots and the treads and the fine sandy particles.
Neil, this is Houston. We're upping.
There seems to be no difficulty in moving around as we suspected. It's even perhaps easier than the simulations of 1/6G that we performed in various simulations on the ground. Absolutely no trouble to walk around. This engine did not leave a crater of any size. It's has about 1 foot clearance on the ground. We're essentially on a very level place here. I can see some evidence of rays emanating from the descent engine, but very insignificant amount.
One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. With those words, Armstrong and then Aldrin begin a 2-hour and 40-minute exploration of moon's surface.
Much of the high desert of the United States. It's different, but it's very pretty out here. Beautiful view. Isn't that something? Magnificent sight out here.
Magnificent desolation.
A miniaturized television camera sends pictures back to Earth as astronauts unveil a plaque marking the occasion.
For those who haven't read the plaque, we'll read the plaque that's on the front landing gear of this lamb. There's two hemispheres, one showing each of the two hemispheres of Earth. Underneath it says, "Dear men from the planet Earth, first set foot upon the moon. July 1969 AD. It came in peace for all mankind. It has the crew members' signatures and the signature of the President of the United States."
Columbia, this is Houston reading you loud and clear, over.
Astronaut Mike Collins, orbiting 60 miles above the moon, comes into radio range as Armstrong and Aldrin set up the American flag.
I believe they're setting up the flag now.
Oh, geez, that's great. Is the lighting halfway decent?
Yes, indeed. They've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the lunar
system.
Neil and Buzz, the President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you. Over.
That would be an honor.
Go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston out.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House, and this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made. I just can't tell you how proud we all are of what you... For every American, this has to be the proudest day of our lives. And for people all over the world, I am sure they too join with America in recognizing what an immense feat this is. Because of what you have done, the heavens have become a part of man's world. And as you talk to us from the Sea of Tranquility, it inspires us to redouble our efforts to bring peace and tranquility to Earth. For one priceless moment in the whole history of man, all the people on this earth are truly one. One in their pride in what you have done, and one in our prayers that you will return safely to Earth.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's a great honor and privilege for us to be here representing not only the United States, but man of peace of all nations, and with interest and a curiosity, and with a vision for the future. Honor for us to be able to participate here today.
Armstrong and Aldrin now spend another hour gathering 60 pounds of moon rocks for scientists back on Earth to study. They set up several scientific experiments which will remain on the moon after they leave, and they test man's ability to move around and explore another world. Then they return their precious samples to the spacecraft cabin. They climb the ladder, and the first expedition on the surface of another world is over.
And verified secure.
Okay.
Cabin pressure coming up. About 2.789 pounds. Up to 3 now. And a replica of the American flag on the lunar surface is now being erected here in the control center. And a replica of the plaque on Tranquility Base has been hung on the wall.
Columbia, Columbia, this is Houston, over.
Roger, Columbia, I see Charlie, how do you read?
Roger, Columbia, this is Houston, reading you loud and clear on Omni Charlie. The crew of Tranquility Base is back inside their base, repressurized. They're in the process of doffing the plosives. Everything went beautifully. Over.
Hallelujah.
Now it is Monday afternoon, July 21st, and in order for Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin to return to their command ship, they first have to blast off the surface of the moon. That's something else nobody's ever done before, and the countdown is tense as the 0 hour approaches. There's a blast of radio static, and then liftoff. Armstrong never did say what that one crater down there was, but it's believed to have been the one full of boulders that he skipped over during the landing.
I'm going right down US-1.
Roger. Okay, I'm going to open up the main shutoff. 90. Okay. Off. 50. Shut down. Eagle, Roger. We copy. It's great. Go.
All right, Roger. You see the Eagle is back of it. Having less tranquility base and leaving behind the replica from our Apollo 11 patch to the outbreak.
Eagle Houston, Roger, we copy. The whole world is proud of you.
Here in Mission Control, the Flight Operations Director, Chris Kraft, commented that he felt like some 500 million people around the world were helping push Eagle off the moon and back into orbit.
Short while later, Mike Collins reports that all three crewmen are back together again in the main spacecraft, and it's almost time to go home.
Columbia, Houston, your friendly white team's going to be on till we get you on the way home, and we'd like to congratulate everybody on a successful rendezvous and a beautiful EVA. It was a great show for everybody, over.
With Eagle's moon landing work completed, the remaining ascent stage is now discarded. It's a piece of space garbage, $40 million.
Eagle looking good. It's holding cabin pressure, and it picked up about 2 feet per second from that Jetson.
To get home, Apollo 11 must fire up its main rocket engine while out of touch with the ground on the far side of the moon. And it's a tense period in Mission Control, waiting 35 anxious minutes to get the results of that burn.
We're now less than 1 minute from reacquiring Apollo 11. When last we heard from the spacecraft, all systems were looking very good, and we were in very good shape for the trans-Earth injection maneuver. At this point, Apollo 10 and Apollo 11 should be about 10,000 pounds lighter and on its way back to Earth.
Seconds later, Apollo 11 comes into radio range.
Hello, Apollo 11. Houston, how did it go? Over.
Help to open up the LRL doors, Charlie.
Roger. We got you coming home. It's well stocked.
To Mike Collins, LRL is a lunar receiving lab, the building in Houston where the crew spends 2 weeks in isolation after the flight.
That place has cleared out a little bit after that rendezvous. You can find a place to sit down almost, huh?
Roger, our mocha's about empty right now. We're taking it a little easy. How's it feel up there to have some company?
Damn good, I'll tell you.
I bet you almost be talking to yourself up there after 10 rounds or so.
No, it's a happy home up here. It'd be nice to have some company. Matter of fact, it'd be nice to have a couple hundred million Americans up here.
Roger, they were with you in spirit.
See what they're getting for their money.
Right, they were with you in spirit anyway, at least that many.
Apollo 11, Commander Neil Armstrong, crewman Buzz Aldrin, and Mike Collins, headed home.
No matter where you travel, it's always nice to get home.
We concur, 11. We'll be happy to have you back.
Apollo 11, man's first journey to the moon.